Breaking news from Trump Jr. Millions shocked. Michael Cantrell, America's freedom fighters dash. While the Trump administration has been plagued by all sorts of issues and problems ever since the president was sworn in last January, the one issue that seems to keep haunting him is that of leaks. Trump has suffered all sorts of leaks from vindictive folk on the left who are very unhappy their pet Hillary Clinton screwed the pooch and lost the 2016 election. According to Fox News, this one it seems was aimed at his son, Donald Trump Jr. An attorney representing Trump Jr. requested that the House Intelligence Committee open an investigation to discover the source of leaks concerning testimony he gave last week. Trump Jr. is the oldest son of the president and he appeared before the committee last week in what was supposed to be a closed session on December 6, the testimony being part of the investigation into Russia messing around with the 2016 election. Here's a few details from the Fox News report in a letter to Representative Mike Conaway, Republican Texas, who has been leading the panel's Russia probe. Attorney Alan Feudorf has accused members of the committee and/or their staff of selectively leaking information provided during the interview to various press outlets, most notably CNN, while Trump Jr. was still speaking to the committee. Feudorf cited two tweets from CNN reporter Manu Rayu, as well as a CNN online story published shortly after the interview, as part of his evidence for the leaks. Feudorf has further alleged that Democrats on the committee, most notably ranking member Representative Adam Schiff, Democrat California, continued to disclose confidential, non-public information to the media after Trump Jr.'s appearance. In an attempt to discredit my client, they did not accurately portray the breadth, scope and substance of the interview, Feudorf wrote, adding that a Republican staff member emailed him the day after the testimony to release him from any confidentiality obligation since others clearly violated that condition before the interview even concluded. Feudorf also accused committee members or staffers of being the source of a CNN report published Friday that initially claimed the Trump campaign had been tipped off early about WikiLeaks documents damaging to Hillary Clinton. The report was later corrected after it was revealed that the alert was already about publicly available information. The initial report from CNN stated an email was sent to the president and his campaign officials on September 4, 2016, containing a link to some documents that had been hacked and stolen from the Democratic National Committee via WikiLeaks. This report also mentioned that Trump Jr. had been asked about this email during his testimony before the committee. But as it turns out, the information reported by CNN, and this will come as a shock to no one, was inaccurate. Several hours after the report was published by the news network, The Washington Post reported the email was actually sent on September 14, that it didn't contain the previously mentioned links, as those had been released a day earlier. What makes this situation so maddening is that those who disseminated this information and passed it on to the press likely knew this information was incorrect, or at the least knew the media reports were incorrect and took no action to correct it, making it clear they had a political axe to grind and were willing to be dishonest about it too. 2.